library computer?
Full personal dossiers on the following names. Dr. Thomas Layton. Anton Caridian. Lieutenant Kevin Riley. And Captain James T. Kirk.
Accomplished. Standing by.
Correlate. Check their past histories. Report any item, any past episode or experience they all have in common.
Affirmative.
I appreciate whatever concern you may have for the ship's company, Mr. Spock.
I will continue, Doctor. According to our library banks, it started on the Earth colony of Tarsus IV when the food supply was attacked by an exotic fungus and largely destroyed. There were over 8,000 colonists and virtually no food. And that was when Governor Kodos seized full power and declared emergency martial law.
I've heard of it.
You may not have heard it all. Kodos began to separate the colonists. Some would live, be rationed whatever food was left. The remainder would be immediately put to death. Apparently, he had his own theories of eugenics.
Unfortunately, he wasn't the first.
Perhaps not. But he was certainly among the most ruthless. To decide arbitrarily who would survive and who would not, using his own personal standards, and then to implement his decision without mercy. Children watching their parents die, whole families destroyed, over 4,000 people. They died quickly, without pain. But they died. Relief arrived, but too late to prevent the executions. And Kodos, there never was a positive identification of his body.
But what has Caridian to do with it?
His history begins almost to the day where Kodos disappeared.
And you think Jem suspects he's Kodos?
He'd better. There were 9 eyewitnesses who survived the massacre, who had actually seen Kodos with their own eyes. Jim Kirk was one of them. With the exception of Riley and Captain Kirk. Every other eyewitness is dead. And my library computer shows that wherever they were, on Earth, on a colony, or aboard ship, the Caridian company of players was somewhere near when they died.
It's unbelievable.
Come.
My report on Lieutenant Riley.
Will he make it?
He's got a good chance.
Can we predict the same for you, Captain?
All right, Mr. Spock, let's have it.
Lieutenant Riley was a witness. So were you. All right. Someone tried to kill him.
Could have been an accident.
You should be told the difference between empiricism and stubbornness, Doctor. I checked with the library computer, just as you did. I got the same information.
Aren't you getting a little out of line, Mr. Spock? My personal business.
It's my personal business when it might interfere with the smooth operation of this ship.
You think that happened?
It could happen.
I don't like anyone meddling in my private affairs, not even my second in command.
Jim, Spock's simply trying to...
I know what he's trying to do, and I don't like it.
It's his job, and you know it.
And you also know that nothing is proven.
Even in this corner of the galaxy, Captain, 2 + 2 = 4. Almost certainly an attempt will be made to kill you. Why do you invite death?
I'm not. I'm interested in justice.
Are you? Are you sure it's not vengeance?
No, I'm not sure. I wish I was. I've done things I've never done before. I've placed my command in jeopardy. From here on, I've got to determine whether or not Caridian is Kodos.
He is.
You sound certain. I wish I could be. Before I accuse a man of that, I've got to be. I saw him once, 20 years ago. Men change. Memory changes. I look at him now, he's an actor. He could have changed his appearance. No. Logic is not enough. I'd feel my way. Make absolutely sure.
What if you decide he is Kodos? What then? Do you play God, carry his head through the corridors in triumph? That won't bring back the dead, Jim.
No. But they may rest easier.